And good morning, everyone. Welcome in, Fat Man on a Mission. Finally got that walking boot off of my foot, and we are back out on the road again. Brought us back to Lubbock. I normally don't repeat, but this is such an incredible event. I had to do it. With me today, Bianca Sias.
Hi.
Bianca, how are you doing today?
Good morning. Oh, wonderful. Wow, what a turnout we have today. So many more. We have triple the amount of volunteers. We increased our numbers by 25%. A few more sponsors and some extra giveaways.
Understand, y'all sold out this year.
We sold out again. We're ecstatic. So it's becoming a thing.
This is awesome. I mean, I can't wait to find out that this one day is going to be the biggest 5K in the Panhandle.
Oh, that would be outstanding.
It is just so much fun. Now, tell us a little bit about the park where we're at today.
Okay, so we are at the Landwehr House at Buddy Holly Park. It's on the east side. Beautiful park with a couple of playa lakes. So the 5K route will take us one big loop. It's very scenic. A couple of small hills, but great otherwise.
No, that hill right around 2.8 miles is not small. It's short, but it's steep.
Yeah.
No, you don't be lying to people because they'll get out here and they'll just fall over. And...
Yeah.
But other than that, yeah, it is an absolutely gorgeous course. Now, we have a good day.
We have a great day. Not like last year where it was torrential downpour right before. So
extra hour of sleep?
Extra hour of sleep. And next year it will be, this is my cousin Margie, another race director.
That's Margie. Y'all saw me talk with her a little bit, about a couple of months ago when I was running through here. Now, I know that we can't, you were kind of trying to keep it a secret, but what about the prizes you have this year?
This year, well, we have a couple of skull giveaways for finisher prizes, but we also have a couple of hotel stays. And then the dish, Go Satellite City, is giving away, I think, a couple of Echo Dots or an Echo Dot.
So. Well, this is pretty cool. You're getting into some... Now, last year, I was so impressed with the swag bag, and this year, you're making not only about the swag, but some really cool prizes.
Yes, yes.
So, this is awesome. Just briefly, tell us a little bit about the history of Dia de los Muertos and all that's involved with that.
Yes, typically, it's a holiday celebrated by Mexicans and Mexican-Americans, celebrating and commemorating the lives of people who've passed on, not just family, but friends. And it's a few days long celebration. Usually the Dia de los Muertos is on the Day of the Dead, which is after All Souls Day. We have an altar with our pictures of these family members. You're supposed to have fruit, you're supposed to have pan de muerte, their favorite drink usually, and you pray for them, you celebrate. And
all right, we're going to do
run has a lot to
quick
do with
Zumba warm up. So, if everybody wants to participate,
out.
If you guys
so
want to participate, it's going to be over here.
What is pan de muerte?
Pan de muerte is like a sweet bread, very close to the pan dulce.
All right, so I understand y'all are supposed to have your your father or grandfather's recipe for
it's
pumpkin empanadas.
Empanadas, yeah, you might have to have Margie get it to you.
Okay.
But we have pumpkin empanadas inside too.
All right, that sounds awesome. I know you've got a lot to do. We're going to get ready. I got some stretches to get in. But once again, everyone, Fat Man on a Mission. We're out here doing the Dia de los Muertos in Lubbock, Texas. Hope you have a chance to join us out here next year because this is one of the best 5Ks that you will find. Once again, for Bianca Sias, her family, and the entire crew here at Dia de los Muertos, I'm David Robinson, your Fat Man on a Mission. We hope to see you on the road.
Bye.